Some of the most uncomfortable, overly passionate, and unplanned pucker-up moments between stars have seemingly happened by surprise as cameras rolled. From Madonna to Meryl Streep, we're diving into the wildest and most uncomfortable kisses that ever happened on live TV.
Gently, that's it.
When it comes to award show moments, few are as iconic as Madonna's three-way smooch with Britney Spears and Christina Aguilera. The pop stars hit the stage at the 2003 MTV VMAs, but things got especially steamy when Madonna kissed Britney, then Christina, right on the lips. Fans were immediately shook, but Spears cleared the air later that year, telling MTV News, "No one slipped anybody the tongue. It was just a kiss. A nice kiss." Christina later explained basically being left out of the media blitz completely, telling Andy Cohen her own kiss with Madonna never made the broadcast.
Did it bug you that they cut away for the Xtina kiss?
They cut away to get Justin's reaction.
Naughty or nice? The shock factor those kisses brought to the VMAs made it one of the most wild and uncomfortable in the show's history. When it comes to spicy celebrity kisses, Amy Schumer and Amber Rose's 2015 MTV Movie Awards moment just might take the cake. The two ladies sat next to each other at the show, and when MTV's kiss cam landed on them during a commercial break, they leaned in and locked lips. In 2016, a year after the famous smooch, Schumer reflected on the moment, tagging Rose and posting to Instagram, quote, "Happy anniversary." Apparently, the kiss brought Schumer and Rose closer together in real life, and the two stars formed a friendship after the show.
It's a lot of laughs, a lot of fun. She's all about girl power. I love it. And she's a great friend.
Host Nick Cannon appeared on America's Got Talent in 2015, and when it came to one contestant, things took a crazy turn.
I am a passion and intimacy expert.
Joanna Kennedy wanted to show the audience how to successfully seduce their partner. Using Cannon as an example, she paired him with a random woman from the audience, coaching him every step of the way.
We're not going to touch yet. Just look at each other. Say hello with your eyes.
But the judges weren't fans of Cannon's so-called skills. The moves he put on the woman failed to impress and resulted in the intimacy coach ultimately getting the boot. One of the most cringeworthy near kisses of all time might be when Jimmy Kimmel asked Rihanna to reenact the famous Lady and the Tramp spaghetti kiss using a Twizzler. Of course, it was all for a good cause. The viral Twizzler challenge was started by New York Collaborates for Autism, so Kimmel proposed the challenge for Autism Awareness Month.
You would put that in one end, and I will put this in my mouth, and
we
will
just... Molly!
As they slowly chewed their way closer to each other, Kimmel finally bailed out. Judging by the laughter and applause, the audience loved it. But the whole thing certainly raised eyebrows. Still, the singer went on to nominate another couple to do the challenge.
Definitely Jim Parsons.
Okay.
Who should his partner be?
Jim Parsons' partner? Maybe also Chewbacca.
One can only imagine Meryl Streep's inner monologue when Sandra Bullock planted a kiss on her lips at the 2010 Critics' Choice Awards. Bullock initiated the iconic moment after lobbing a sneer at Streep, when she famously beat her out of the Best Actress Award. Of course, it was all in good fun. On the Graham Norton show, the actress claimed that Streep was asking for it, quipping,
"She was egging me on this entire time.
It was
no holds barred. I had to take Meryl down."
Bullock also claimed that Streep later sent her three dead orchids after she won the Academy Award in 2010 with a note that read, "Die, b***h. Love, Meryl." One Direction has one of the most rabid fan bases in the world, and their followers stay up to date on their romantic endeavors. But one of Niall Horan's most public kisses of 2012 wasn't with a crush, but with actor Dustin Hoffman. On The Late Show with David Letterman, Hoffman appeared alongside all of the 1D bandmates, and was apparently feeling extra flirty that night. He first asked Letterman,
You mind if I sit on your lap?
No, you're not sitting on my lap.
After Hoffman sat down, he then planted a highly theatrical kiss on Horan that left him squirming and trying to come up for air. These two stars are 57 years apart, so fans of the then 19-year-old Horan were understandably put off by the wild moment. Let's be honest, some kisses are better left in the bedroom. But The Notebook co-stars Rachel McAdams and Ryan Gosling left it all on the floor at the 2005 MTV Movie Awards. While some Hollywood couples may try to keep their personal lives under wraps, real-life couple Gosling and McAdams let fans in on some wild PDA. things got beyond hot and heavy between the two stars that night as they accepted the award for Best Kiss. Sure, they initially won for their film work, but everyone forgot about that after seeing their steamy onstage makeout sesh.
It has got to stop.
Noah?
He's a nice boy, but he is not for you!
Alas, on-camera PDA doesn't always equal happily ever after, and the couple ultimately called it quits 2 years later. Check out one of our newest videos right here! Plus, even more list videos about your favorite celebs are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.